And our word for today on this Tuesday of the 31st week in Ordinary Time, this Tuesday, November the 7th, our word for today is peace. Peace is our word for today, and here to talk about it, the one, the only, Kendra Von Esh. Good morning, Kendra. Can't wait to hear your thoughts on our word for today.
No, can't wait to share them. But first, can I just say to all of the listeners, as you guys are looking to approach your fundraising for next week, that sometimes we don't know how to evangelize. Sometimes we bite our tongues and we're not exactly sure how to share the faith because maybe we're too shy or we're really early on our journey and we're afraid that if we don't know everything about the Catholic Church that we cannot state anything about our faith journey. And I just want to say that donating to Annunciation Radio can be that gift, that evangelization that you give to the next listener that's going to stumble on this channel and is going to find God in these wonderful people who run the programs and who are out there just trying to bring them to Jesus's heart. So if any of you have a little Holy Spirit movement in your soul right now, please donate, because I myself, when I was on the journey 11 years ago, it was before podcasts and YouTube and all that kind of stuff. Like, I fell across a Christian radio station and they impacted me. So you guys are evangelizing out there just by donating. Okay. That's my soapbox. Well, and
that's a beautiful reminder.
And this real quickly too, we can't afford to pay Kendra nothing if you don't. Oh yeah, we pay you nothing. Never mind. But we do have other bills. We have other bills.
And they don't pay me anything, people. They don't. Trust me. This is what we do. You know, we're out here helping you and just get closer to God and the beautiful Catholic faith. Okay. Amen. So the word peace, which was something that I sought out and I didn't even know that it was peace. I thought I was seeking happiness. So I think about in the Christmas time, when you see the word peace, you see the word joy. I never really used those in my secular life. It just wasn't vocabulary words that I did say most often. But I know that that's now what I was seeking. Because if we look at the readings today, it says, "In you, O Lord, I have found my peace." And for all of you out there who are seeking that peace that surpasses all understanding, it can be yours. But you got to look in the right place. You've got to look for God. You've got to ask Mary to help her bring you to her son's sacred heart, where we can all rest, just like St. John, putting our head on the chest of Jesus, even in the midst of the boat rocking. And we're thinking, Lord, are you going to let us perish? No, no, I'm right here. Peace be with you. You know, how many times do we hear, do not be afraid? And so I'd like to say that my peace didn't come until I humbly surrendered to God. I remember in the first couple of years of my journey, I was on this mortal sin cleanup. I kept falling. I kept running to reconciliation. I kept asking God to be that peace for me in this world where I just kept falling, kept getting upset with myself, kept getting mad at myself. I mean, how pathetic am I? I did it again. And then when I let God in and I finally said, kind of almost in a humiliating way, more so than humility, like, I am pathetic, God. I don't know how to do this. And at that time in my life, I never said those things. I always figured things out, and I looked at myself as my own God. Me, myself, and I was my own Holy Trinity. I was a corporate and executive, an executive in corporate America. It was me that got me here. So the whole humility aspect is where the peace is going to come. And one more thing, we've got to pay attention. Don't let those emotions of anger or fear, worry, despair, doubt creep into your mind. The minute they do, just as St. Paul says, grab that thought, make it obedient to Christ, cast it out, use deliverance prayers in the name of Jesus Christ. I renounce the spirit of fear and worry and doubt and despair. And then ask the Lord to fill you with his peace, his love, his joy, so that you can be that witness to everyone around you in whatever circumstance God is allowing in your life right now.
Mm. Amen. The greatest gift that we can receive is that spirit of peace and contentment. I mean, how many people in the world are truly peaceful and filled with contentment? If you achieve that, which can only come through the Lord, then you have it all, really.
And those people stand out too, don't they?
Yeah. Hey, I want to say real quickly, Deacon Dan Brayer just let us know, reminded us, St. Thomas More in Bowling Green has Mass on every Tuesday and Thursday at 5:30 p.m.
Oh,
so there with
right.
our good friend mm-hmm. Father Jeff Walker. Tuesdays and Thursdays Mass at St. Thomas More in Bowling Green, 5:30. Mm-hmm. So plenty of opportunities to add Mass, the most powerful prayer we have, to your regiment today.
Yeah. Kendra, have a great day. Thank you.
God bless. God bless.